What's up guys, it's Alex here, your friendly Reef Talk. Now a couple of weeks ago I saw a video called Top 5 Equipment I Can't Do Without by my fellow YouTuber Mr. Salty's Reef. And I absolutely loved the video. In fact, I loved it so much I've stolen the idea and made my own version. Now this isn't intended as a definitive list of the equipment you absolutely must have, it's just 5 things that I find really useful in day-to-day life. Now if it's your first time here at the channel and you want weekly reefing content stolen from other YouTubers, make sure you subscribe and hit the bell so you don't miss out on anything. Right, let's get stuck in. First on my list of equipment I couldn't do without is my RODI auto shutoff. RODI filters and forgetful reefers go together like water and electricity. If you walk away from your filter without setting a timer, it will fill up your container and keep on producing water until your missus shouts, "Alex, you've done it again." You can get simple float valves that shut off your filter when the container's full, but I've gone for the more reliable optical sensor. When the sensor is triggered, a solenoid valve closes, cuts off the water supply, and prevents a flood. And the main benefit for me is that it allows me to have my RODI filter on overnight, which is handy for me as I need to filter over 50 litres of water every week for my weekly water change. Next up is an elbow grease saver, citric acid. Cleaning any reef kit is a pain in the behind, but it really makes a massive difference to performance, and I'm always amazed at how big my waves are after I've cleaned my MP40 wet sides. But soaking in water mixed with citric acid for a couple of hours does the hard work, leaving you to simply wipe away the algae. It's also dirt cheap and is supposedly more gentle on plastic than vinegar is, and you can also use it to descale your kettle. Number 3 on my list of equipment I couldn't do without is my Tunzi algae magnet. There are loads of options for algae scrapers, but the only two worth your money are the Tunzi and the Flipper. I have both, but I prefer the Tunzi and find it does a better job of chomping through the algae on my glass. And that's whether it's the light dusting of algae you get day to day, or the rock solid coralline that builds up over time. Tanks look so much better when they've just been scraped, and having the Tunzi genuinely makes me do it more often. The only downside is that the wet side doesn't float, whereas the Flipper does. You can get an optional life jacket for it that does make it float, but I personally find that makes the scraper too thick, and it splashes water over the top of my tank when the floating side sucks back into place. And the runner-up is my IKEA automatic cabinet lights. It's a small thing, but having your sump cabinet light up when the doors open without having to flick a switch is genuinely fantastic. Now being IKEA, they're modular, so you can add as many as you can fit in your cabinet for extra brightness. And while these are designed for less humid spaces like wardrobes, mine haven't shown any sign of rusting in the 18 months I've had them. Now before I tell you the number one on my list, there are a couple of honourable mentions. I have an auto top up made by a UK company called Refloat, which combined with a 60 litre freshwater reservoir means my salinity level is maintained nicely with minimal input from me. And my GHL doser not only takes care of alkalinity and calcium, but also allows me to dose as little as 0.1 millilitres at a time, meaning I can use it to dose trace elements like iodine instead of adding the stuff manually every day. And there are two bits of kit that give me peace of mind. The Ecotech battery backup will keep my tank oxygenated in the event of a power outage, and my Senai Reef will send me an email if the temperature in my tank swings or if the auto top-off fails and makes the sump water level drop. But the number one piece of kit I couldn't do without is my Refloat auto water changer. I've done a review of this, so check out the card at the top of the screen for full details, but essentially you just add 2.2 kilograms of salt to 53 litres of water, plug it in, and it does your water change for you. No large vats and no splashing water everywhere. I haven't missed a weekly water change in the 2 years I've had it, whereas I used to see water changes as a total chore and looked for any excuse to skip them, all of which makes this a worthy winner of any can't do without list. Now I'll put links to the Mr. Salty video in the description, as well as to all the kit I've mentioned in here, so go and check that out. And if you enjoyed the video, give me a thumbs up and subscribe for next week, and until next time, happy reefing.